गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, आर यू हियरिंग माय वॉइस? गुड आफ्टरनून, नागेंद्र बाबू, विनिपिस्तुंदा?
सर नो,
वॉइस इज क्लियर? వాయిస్ క్లియర్ ఉందా నాది?
ఉంది సార్.
ఓకే రైట్. ఓకే, గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ ఆల్. దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ క్లాస్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఏ షార్ట్ బ్రేక్ డ్యూ టు యూజీ ఎగ్జామ్స్. బిఫోర్ ద బ్రేక్ వీ కంప్లీటెడ్ the first module in our the fifth paper, cultural history of India. We completed all concepts in our first module of Dalit history of India, sir, cultural history of India. From today onwards we'll start the first module from the Dalit history of India, Dalit movements in India, 1900 to 1940s. Among the Dalit movements, or before going to the Dalit movements detail, we have to see the definition and term, are the definition and meaning of the Dalit. And we'll see the various theories regarding the history of Dalit. You are well aware that Dalits take various communities. You find only in Indian society. You cannot see such a social structure in any other country of the world. You just find in only the Indian context. Among the social structure or among the caste structure in India, Dalit is a lower class or a lower section within the caste system, are within the social order of India. You cannot see the section of the Dalit within the Varnashrama Dharma. Within the Varnashrama Dharma, you see only the four Varnas. You are already aware. Among the four Varnas, you cannot find the structure of the Dalit, or a class of the Dalit, or a caste of the Dalit, or a communities of the Dalit. You find only the four classes: Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. Okay, so Dalit is a concept which is outside of the Varnashrama Dharma. Outside of the Varna system. Okay, that's why we call it as the outcast. Sometimes we call it as Atishudras, because these all Dalits cannot in the inclusion of the Shudras also. Okay, they are outcasts of the Shudras. So that's why we call the Dalits as a Atishudras. And sometimes we call it as the Harijans and Untouchables. There are various names according to the various regions of the Indian territories. Okay, so before going to see all these things, we see about the term Dalit in order. Okay, we'll start with the things which is closely related to the term Dalit. Okay, So the word Dalit in the recent past gained so much attention that its meaning has gained international recognition. It mainly refers to the so-called untouchables of Indian caste system. It is used in the modern times in literature, in the realm of politics, economics, cultural, anthropology, religious studies, and theology. Only in the last decade, the term Dalit is employed in the philosophical literature. Linguistically, the term Dalit has its root both in Indian and Hebrew language. The term Dalit in Sanskrit is both a noun and object. As a noun, Dalit may be used for all three genders. You already have genders like masculine, feminine, and neuter. And etymologically, the term is derived from the Sanskrit root, the word dal, which means the crack or open, split, and so on. It's a break. When used as a noun or a adjective, it means burst, split, broken, or torn, downtrodden, scattered, crushed, destroyed, oppressed, subjugated, suppressed, and broken. Okay, these are various terms for a meaning for the Dalit. Prior to the usage of the term Dalit, the so-called untouchable called or outcasts were designated by the various names. Okay, so the Vedic literature depicts them as a dasas, dasyus, asuras, antajas, avarnas, nishadas, mlechas, chandalas, panchamas. Okay, these are the various terms you refer from the various literary works of the Vedic age. This name designates the Dalits in a derogatory manner, in the sense that Dalits are unholy, devilish, untouchables, enemies, and outcasts. These naming depicts social is upper class or upper caste attitude towards the Dalits and ill treatment meted over the Dalits for the centuries. Okay, when you observe, Dalits had no such privilege in the society. Okay, they are a downtrodden. They are observed as a downtrodden or outside of the social structure. Okay, so it is not surprising to note that in every state of India, the Dalit are unfortunately but purposefully identified or heartless man. In Tamil Nadu, the Dalits are identified as the Pariyas, Pallas, and Chekliyas, which as well depict the subcaste among the Dalit. In Andhra Pradesh, they are known as the names of Mala, Madigas, that citate the Dalits as untouchables. Okay, so apart from these Mala and Madigas, you have aware that many other 50 castes also comes under these Dalits. In Kerala, a state known for its high literacy rate for many years, the Dalits are called as the Polayas, Charmans, and Ejwas. In Karnataka, Dalits are known as the names as Polayas and Idigas. In Uttar Pradesh, they called by names such as Chamas and Pasis. In Punjab and Haryana, they branded as Valmikis and Bangis. In Maharashtra, they are categorized as Mahars and Mangas. Okay, so apart from these, many other names also this, like Mochis, Matangas, and other names also you find. Nearly 450 names all over the India you find to identify the Dalits at present also. Okay. So, thus we draw the geopolitical Indian map. It will solely depict the caste category of the pigeon holding the Dalit community as an untouchables. These identifications speaks for themselves. The vulgarity of the caste system and their humiliation that Dalits undergo in the social history of India. They are not the names by which Dalits call themselves, but they are the pejorative names which the upper caste people identified the Dalits. They express strong sensibilities of contempt, hatred, and inhumanity towards the Dalit community. Interestingly, Mahatma Gandhi had his share in calling the Dalit by names. He designated the Dalits as the Harijans. The term Hari means the divine or a god, but an inferior god in comparison to the supreme god known as the Brahma. And the term Jans means the people. Thus, in combination, the term Harijans implied that Dalits are people of God. But then, this name of Dalit as a Harijans did not cultivate many positive attitudes towards Dalit. Instead, it only continued to reinstate and serve the negative attitude of the upper caste towards the Dalit. This naming as the Harijans further implied the meaning that Dalits are but the children who are born to the Devadas. Okay, Devadas referred to the system of prostitution that was prevalent among the priestly communities for reasons of sexual exploitation of the selected women, but unfortunately enjoyed socially approval and religious sanction. Okay, so many intellectuals of Dalits or Dalit community which oppose the term which is Harijan used by the Mahatma Gandhi, because the term meaning nothing but they are the sons of the God. Okay, so since the period of Gandhi, the term Harijans gained currency to continue identify the treat the Dalits in the nickname. Okay, so the Gandhian effort to name the Dalits as children of God did not have any positive effect, but it continued to reinstate the excessive caste mentality only. Okay, so many intellectuals from the Dalit community, which the term Harijan, they see in a negative manner. Okay, so when you see the meaning of the term Dalit in the contemporary period, James Massey, a scholar in Dalit social history, in his book on Dalits in India, observed that the present usage of the term Dalits goes back to the 19th century, when the Marathi social reformer and revolutionary personality Mahatma Jyotirao Phule used it to describe the outcasts and the untouchables as the oppressed and the broken victims of the Indian caste ridden society. It is also believed that this usage was first coined by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. However, he employed the term the scheduled castes or depressed class in the most of his speeches and writings. The term Dalit gained momentum in 1970s due to Dalits' assertion to human dignity by the Dalit Panther movement of Maharashtra. Such a usage of the term is constant reminder of the untold sufferings and age-old oppression, denoting the fact that Dalit community for centuries is treated a subhuman within the social parameters of Indian caste system. Besides its common usage, the term Dalit today is specially used for those people who, on the basis of the caste distinction, have been considered outcast. They were outcast because they were not, according to the architects of the system, to be included in the fourfold graded system, caste structure of Indian society. On the basis of this status, they were made to bear extreme kinds of responsibility in the form of oppression for centuries, which made them almost lose their inhumanness. Thus, the term Dalit for its people is not mere a title. It is both an expression of their community identity in the Indian social history to assert their rights and to restore their identity with dignity and self-worth. It has well depicts their continuous struggle for liberation. It is both a reminder of social caste oppression and a renewed identity to reassure their affirmation as a people of a nation. Okay, so these are certain things regarding the meaning of the term and synonymous of the term Dalit. Okay, so when you see the history of the Dalit in India, or Dalit are a prominent social structure in Indian caste hierarchy. So in the hierarchy, you find the outcast and various names for the Dalit also. But when you see the history about the Dalit, you cannot find a proper source how the term Dalit evolved. Okay, so the evolution of the term Dalit, you don't find such a sources to know clearly about the evolution of the term. Okay, so we have certain a few sources how the term has evolved and how the caste system has evolved and how the social structure has emerged in India. Okay, so you can observe from the Indus Valley period onwards. Okay, so when you see the history, a brief history of the term Dalit, it is a fact that we lack much of written source about the history of the Dalit people. However, from the available sources, we shall make an attempt, make sense of the life story of Dalits. The queries that draw our immediate concern include: what is the identity of the Dalit people in the social history of India? How Dalits are considered and treated in the Indian tradition or Indian social order? What is social locus in which the Dalits are situated? What are the constituting factors that construct the identity of the Dalits as untouchables? And how do the Dalits view themselves or reassert their human dignity and identity? There could be a number of other related issues that can be raised in the context of reconstructing the life and identity of Dalits, for these are fundamental and interrelated issues that go to shed light on the history of the Dalit. Okay, so Dalits as a people of nation remain to be very ancient and highly developed in its beginnings. They are the aboriginals amongst ancient Asian civilization. Okay, ancient Indian civilization. However, the Dalit as untouchable, unseeable and unappreciable, etc., are recorded in the posts of the Vedas. This means that the life of Dalits as a outcast is of later period, namely the period of Vedas. It is generally agreed that the Vedic literature and its world belong to the Aryan civilization. Among the famous Rigvedas, the Rigveda contain ample evidence towards the rigid adherence and practice of the caste social order. This evidently implies that the prevalence of the casteism came into existence right from the Vedic period, whose period is roughly traceable to 1000 BC. Okay, so you are already aware that the evolution of the caste system, which is started from the Indus Valley period onwards, and during the Indus Valley period, on the basis of various occupations, their social structure or the society may be divided. On the basis of the occupation, there is certain division you find at the Indus Valley. When you see in the Vedic and later Vedic, there is a certain literary sources you find. Within the literary sources, there is a source of origin of the caste system, not caste system, the origin of the Varnashrama Dharma. Okay, so it is, you clearly see from the theory of Purusha Sukta, which is from the 10th mandala of the Rig Veda. So according to Purusha Sukta theory, there is a evolution of the four Varnas, Brahmin, Kshatriya, and Vaishyas and Sudras. Okay, so these are originated from the from the Vishnu. Okay, so after that, this whole Varnashrama Dharma again scattered into various classes. The classes may be based on the various occupations which the people they followed. Okay, so for this you have certain source from the Rigvedic time onwards. Okay, so in Rigvedic text you find a para that is which is given by a unknown personality which identify himself as and his family. Okay, so he himself saying that said that my mother is a grain grinder and also my father is a physician and myself as a student are following certain occupation. Okay, this clearly shows that we don't find a certain rigidity at the Rigvedic period, but you find certain division. Okay, so it may be the starting point of the evolution of caste system in India. Okay, so in the same context, you find the rigidity within the later Vedic time. Okay, so the scattering of the classes or the scattering or evolution of the classes may started from the Rigvedic onwards. Okay, so for this, you also support with a theory that you find the various names regarding the outcasts of the Aryans, like the Dasa, Dasyu. You find these two terms in the one or two contexts in the Rigvedic text also. Okay, so I'll give a detail later. So the people of Vedic culture, broadly known as the Aryans. Okay, Aryans is a tribe at the time which came from the other parts of the Indian subcontinent. Maybe they are from the Central Asia. Okay, it means they are the migrants to the Indian subcontinent. Okay, they are not original or the indigenous people of the Indian subcontinent. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so the people of Vedic culture, broadly known as the Aryans, people, the Dravidian culture, that between these two cultures, there existed continuous conflict between these two cultures. Many of the Vedic hymns evidently imply the prevalence of conflicts between these two communities. As a result, the people of Vedic community were the winners of the conflicts. Okay, so it means what? The Aryan is a race which came to Indian subcontinent from other parts of the Indian subcontinent and invaded the indigenous people which are already existed in Indian subcontinent. Okay, so it means it's clearly saying that the Aryan race is outside of the Indian subcontinent. Okay, Indian territories. They are the race other than the indigenous race at that time. Okay, so Sayulu, you may mute your audio once. Okay. Mute your audio. Okay. Many of Vedic hymns evidently imply the prevalence of the conflict between these two communities, and as a result of the people, Vedic community were the winners of the conflict. To the claim that the historical root of the Dalits as untouchable community is intrinsically connected with the caste world, view of Aryans can be evidenced from various verses of Rigveda. Most of the Vedic hymns or texts are addressed to Lord Indra, and they narrate rivalry between the Aryans and Aryas and the Dasyas. Okay, so Dasyas are Dasus, the excluded community by the Aryas. Many scholars, many historians and scholars, you see the Srivastava, Kapoor Singh, Ambedkar, Smith, A.L. Basham, Chattopadhyaya, Chanda, D.D. Koshambi and others agree to the fact that the destruction of the Indus Valley civilization and contents of the hymns of the Rigveda are related. Okay, so both these sources point towards a war conflict among the different groups of the people. This has a direct relationship with the history of Dalit, because the time of war conflict of these opposing groups will be the beginnings of the history of Dalits. The status of Dalits or Dalits as the outcast is direct consequence of the instruction of Vedic social order, that is the caste system. Okay, this is the basic point of Indian caste system, which evaluated later. Okay, scholars like Ambedkar and Navaratan, S. Ram, Rajaram and Srikant Ji, Talagiri and K.D. Setna and hold the opinion that the Aryans, the people of Vedic culture and the Dravidians that include the Dalit people belong to Indian nation, and therefore both these cultures are view of the Indian origin. Okay, the majority of the intellectual class or the majority of scholars are supporting the theory of the indigenous were the Dalits. Okay, so scholars namely Jyotiba Phule, Ghosh, Srivastava, Chanda, Chattopadhyay and Patan, Swami Dharma, Tirtha and Suniti Kumar Chatterjee and Jawaharlal Nehru, D.D. Koshambi, Harman Kulke and Rudharmund and many others are the opinion that Aryans are not of indigenous origin and they are invaders into India. Okay, so according to them, Aryans are the immigrants who originally settled in Iran and Plateau and later periods were invaders into the Indian territories. Okay, so that's we already discussed that. So many scholars also supporting that they are the outsiders of the Indian subcontinent. They are not the indigenous people. Okay, so at the time of Aryan invasion, the people who are in the place of Indus Valley, who are in the territories of our region of Indus Valley, were the indigenous people. Okay, so they are the original people, are the original people of Indian society at that time. Okay, they are maybe migrated to southern part or southern regions when the Aryan invasion has taken place. Okay, so by the Aryan invasion, the indigenous people are the existing people who are in the region of the Indus and other adjoining part of Indus River, they gradually migrated towards the southern part of India. Okay, so when you see the linguistic basis, these people who are following a language or a linguistic group called as the Dravidian. Okay, so the Dravidian language followed group called as the Dravidians, right? So these may be the indigenous people. Okay, this is also not a theory of mine. Okay, this is also theory which is supported the majority of the Indians. Okay, so due to the invasion of Aryans, the existing people who are gradually migrated towards the southern part. Okay, so the southern part, who migrated to southern part, who followed a linguistic group of the linguistic based races, we call as a Dravidian. Okay, so the Dravidian may be the original race of the India, or they may be indigenous people when the Aryan invasion has taken place. Okay, so thus many scholars came to believe that the Aryans are but the ancient Iranian, and therefore they are not the indigenous origin, which in turn mean that Aryans were invaders in ancient India. The Aryans, during their effort to Indian settlement, waged continuous war against the Dravidians. Okay, so Dravidians is a race speak the Dravidian language. Okay, they were gradually migrated to the southern part of India. In spite of the differences of the claims among us, these theories, yet there are points of the commonalities, namely that Dalits as untouchables did not exist during the period of Mohenjo-daro, Harappa, and Indus Valley civilization. That Dalit has untouchables originated, came into existence during the Vedic periods due to the Vedic social order, that is the caste system named the Varashtama Dharma in Vedic literature. Thus, we can therefore can confident to assert that the roots of Dalit history is traceable to the aspects of the destruction of Mohenjo-daro, Harappa, and Indus Valley civilizations, and the race and settlement of Aryan race and its allied practice of the caste system. The Dalits have been reduced to their present state by centuries of exploitation and survivability, right from the establishment of the Aryan rule and its allied religious practices and taboos. It is revealing to note that Upanishads, which is considered as the culmination or end portion of the Vedas, doesn't have reference to existence of outcasts as a fifth category enlisted outside of the fourfold caste categories. For example, Chandogya Upanishad not only refers to the three upper castes, but also compares Chandala is a outcast, which is a dog or a swine. Okay, so many Vedic literary works also supporting that no outcast as origin or no outcast is inclusion of a Varnashrama Dharma. It is the exclusion of the Varnashrama Dharma. Okay, so the outcast are a present called terms Dalit or untouchable or Harijan or Adishudras or Chandalas or Mlechas. These are a synonyms or the similar terms used for Dalit. They were not mentioned in the Vedic literature. Okay, so this evolution of caste system may started during this during the period of Guptas. Then onwards, the groups of these Dalits scattering are evolved into various communities. Okay, so these are the various things regarding the term Dalit and a short history of Dalit. Okay, so we'll see these very detailed manner in the further modules. Okay, so this is about the meaning and the definition of the Dalit. And tomorrow we'll see the various approaches regarding the Dalits and the evolution of Dalit or the evolution of caste system in India. Okay, you'll see various approaches given by various historians and scholars. Okay, so this is end of the class today. You have any queries or doubts, you may welcome to us. Any doubts? Anyone may speak. हेलो यू कैन स्पीक एनीवन कैन स्पीक Are you getting my voice clearly?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting my screen? Are you getting my shared screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, right. Okay, this is end of the class today. Tomorrow we are going to see various approaches are the Dalit historiography, which is a important concept to know how the ideology of a Dalit which evolved, and also how the Dalits were emerged, and how the term Dalit which given by the various authors in various conditions. Okay, so tomorrow we're going to see about the Dalit historiography. Okay, so among them the subaltern historiography, the important one, so we'll highlight the subaltern historiography tomorrow. Right. Any queries? Any doubts? You may ask now. Otherwise, I will end up the meeting today. Sailu.
Good afternoon.
I am on a doubt on that.
Good
afternoon. Ah, that might be a doubt loss, I guess. Okay, all of you can mute yourself so that I will see your faces. Nagaraju, Suresh, Nagendra Babu, you can mute yourself, mute your videos once. Unmute your videos once. You can open up your videos. Okay, Nagendra Babu. Good, Suresh.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Suresh, unmute your video. Okay, right. Nagaraju, okay, na? Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay, Nagendra Babu.
Clear, sir.
Meer emanna ibbandi unte meeru inform cheyochu. Okay, so ఎట్లా ఉండాలి అనేది కూడా మీరు చెప్పొచ్చు. దాన్ని మేము ఫాలో అవుతుంటాం. ఎందుకంటే ఇప్పుడు ఇది క్లాస్ రూమ్ కాదు కాబట్టి, సో అట్లీస్ట్ మేము కొంచెం అంటే క్లియర్గా మీకు చెప్పే ప్రయత్నం చేస్తాం. కాబట్టి మీకు ఎట్లా ఉండాలనేది మీరు చెప్పొచ్చు. ఈజ్ ఇట్ ఓకే? మేము ఫాలో అయ్యేది కరెక్టేనా? లేదా ఎలా ఉండాలో మీరు చెప్పొచ్చు. మిగతా టీచర్లు ఏమైనా చెప్తున్నారా? క్లాసులు తీసుకున్నారా? హరిశంకర్ సార్, జూలు నాగేశ్వర్ సార్ తీసుకుంటున్నారా? అటెండ్ అవుతున్నారా మిగతా టీచర్స్ క్లాసెస్? అదే ఎవరు రావట్లేదు, ఎవరు ప్రాబ్లం ఉందో చెప్తే నేను సాల్వ్ చేస్తా అట్లానే. ఏ టీచర్ తో
ఉన్నారు?
నాగేశ్వర సార్ది లింక్ రావట్లేదు. మీకు ముందుగా లింక్ పంపించట్లేదు. ఓకే, హరిశంకర్ సార్
ఇంత మటుకు లేదు సార్. హరిశంకర్ సార్ క్లాస్ అయితే
క్లాస్ తీసుకోవాలి ఇంతవరకు. ఒకటే క్లాస్ అయింది ఇప్పటివరకు. ఓకే, ఆల్రెడీ మీ గ్రూప్ ఉంది కాబట్టి ఆ గ్రూప్ లో మీరు టీచర్లను అడగచ్చు. ఓకే, సో ఎందుకంటే ఈ మంత్ మొత్తం కూడా ఇదే ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసెస్ తో జరుగుతాయి. సో కొంతవరకు మేము మ్యాక్సిమం సిలబస్ కంప్లీట్ చేసే ప్రయత్నం చేస్తాం. ఓకే, సో ఆల్రెడీ నేను మీకు ఏదైతే మెటీరియల్ మీకు చెప్తున్నానో ఆ మెటీరియల్ ఆల్రెడీ పోస్ట్ చేస్తున్నా. ఓకే, మీరు చదువుకోవచ్చు. అట్లానే ఏదైతే వీడియో నేను ఏదైతే చెప్తున్నానో అదే వీడియో మీకు ఆల్రెడీ పోస్ట్ చేస్తున్నా, మీరు వినొచ్చు. సో మీకు ఇంకా ఇంకేమన్నా ఫర్దర్గా ఇంకేమన్నా అవసరం అయితే మీరు చెప్పండి. మీరు ఇంకా ఈజీగా చదువుకోవటానికి ఇంకేమన్నా అవసరం అయితే చెప్పండి ఎగ్జామినేషన్ పర్పస్లో. అంటే మీరు మొబైల్లో చదువుతారు కాబట్టి, సో మేము పంపించిన ఏదైతే మెటీరియల్ ఉంటుందో చాలా తక్కువ మంది దాన్ని తీసుకుంటారు. సో మొబైల్లో చదువుకుంటారు కాబట్టి మొబైల్ ఇంకా ఈజీగా మీకు అంటే మంచిగా ఉండటానికి చదువుకోవటానికి ఏమైనా చేయవచ్చా? మీ ఐడియాస్ ఏమైనా ఉంటే చెప్పండి, అది ఫాలో అవ్వండి. సురేష్ ఎలా ఉన్నావు? చెప్పండి, మీకు ఇంకేమైనా ఐడియాస్ ఉంటే చెప్పొచ్చు, అది ఫాలో అవుతాం. ఎందుకంటే మేము ఇక్కడే కూర్చొని చెప్తున్నాం కాబట్టి మీరు చెప్పొచ్చు, ఇలా చేయండి సార్ అని చెప్పొచ్చు, ఐడియాస్ ఇవ్వచ్చు. ఓకే, ఎనీహౌ థ్యాంక్ యూ. సో డైలీ అంటే మండే నుంచి అంటారు, రేపు ఉండదు కాబట్టి మండే నుంచి ఇక రెగ్యులర్గా మా క్లాసులు తీసుకుందాం. ఓకే, సో మళ్ళా 12th తర్వాత మళ్ళీ గ్యాప్ రావచ్చేమో. 12th నుంచి ఆల్రెడీ ఫైనల్ ఇయర్ ఎగ్జామ్ స్టార్ట్ అవుతాయి కాబట్టి మేబీ 1 week మళ్ళీ గ్యాప్ వస్తుందేమో. 12 వరకు ఎంతవరకు అయితే అయితే ఆ సిలబస్ కంప్లీట్ చేసుకుందాం. ఓకే, సో ఆల్రెడీ హాస్టల్ వాళ్ళకి ఓపెన్ చేస్తారు, మీకు రాదు, మీకు ఓపెన్ చేస్తారు, మీకు ఓపెన్ చేయరు. ఓన్లీ ఫైనల్ ఇయర్స్ ఎగ్జామ్స్ ఎవరికి జరుగుతున్నాయి వాళ్ళకి మాత్రం బేబీ ఒక 2-3 days తర్వాత ఓపెన్ చేస్తారు
అనుకుంటున్నాను.
హలో, రైట్. ఇంకోటి ఏంటంటే అంటే మీకు ఇంకా 1 month తర్వాత నాకు ఏదైనా మీకు డైరెక్ట్ క్లాస్ అనే 1 month తర్వాత మీకు క్లాసులు ఉంటాయి. అంటే డైరెక్ట్ క్లాసులు ఉంటే ఇఫ్ ఇన్ నవంబర్. ఓకే, నవంబర్ వరకు అయితే ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసులే జరుగుతాయి. సో ఇంకా మీకు ఎలాంటి డౌట్స్ ఉన్నా సరే మీరు ఆల్రెడీ గ్రూప్ ఉంది కాబట్టి గ్రూప్లో అడగచ్చు. ఓకే, అంటే మీరు చదివితే మీకు డౌట్లు వస్తాయి కాబట్టి కొంచెం చదివే ప్రయత్నం చేయండి. ఇంకోటి ఏంటంటే ఆల్రెడీ కల్చరల్ హిస్టరీ ఆఫ్ ఇండియాలో 1st మాడ్యూల్ కంప్లీట్ చేశాను, అది ఆర్డర్లో ఆల్రెడీ నేను పోస్ట్ చేశాను, మెటీరియల్ చూడండి. ఓకే, సో ఇది దళిత్ మూమెంట్స్, ఇదొకటి కంప్లీట్ చేసుకుందాం. ఈ ఎప్పుడు 12th లోపు ఉన్నటువంటి కాన్సెప్ట్ 1st మాడ్యూల్ కంప్లీట్ చేద్దాం. తర్వాత ఇంకో పేపర్ ఉంది నాది. ఓకే, సోషల్ అండ్ ఎకనామిక్ హిస్టరీ ఆఫ్ మోడర్న్ ఇండియా. సో ఇది 1st మాడ్యూల్ అయిపోయిన తర్వాత అందులో 1st మాడ్యూల్ కంప్లీట్ చేసుకుందాం. ఓకే, సో ఇట్లా ఆర్డర్లో వెళ్ళిపోదాము. మీకేమైనా డౌట్స్ ఉంటే మీరు చెప్పొచ్చు. ఇంకా మనకి టైం ఉంది, సో అది కట్ అయ్యేలో మీరు ఏదన్నా చెప్పాలనుకుంటే చెప్పండి. ఏం లేవా?
ఏం లేదు సార్. ఏం లేదు.
ఓకే, మరి నేను ఎండ్ చేయనా మీటింగ్.
ఓకే సార్.
ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్.